Alright, here we are for game two on the play. This hand looks great. We can play a quick Pelucranos and then Rakdos return away his hand. Both of those things sound excellent. Okay, our opponent has a flavored hoplite. And I think we want to put that on the bottom. We have plenty of mana in this hand already. So, this feels like a bluff to me. He could have a Jani's Presence, I suppose. It's probably not a bluff worth calling, that's for sure. And he has another guy, but seems to be short on mana. So we'll just make a Pelucranos and pass. Alright, well, things are going to go downhill for our opponent very quickly here. We'll crash in with Pelucranos. And then I think he's just gonna chump here? Or is he gonna try to save it? He is gonna save his guy. Okay. Well, that's not really a big deal. The question now is whether we want to just monstrous to kill this favorite hoplite, or whether we want to play Sylvan Caryatid to help set up a Rakdos return for his whole hand. Let's see. He has 6 cards left. So if we play this and a land, and then we can play a land next turn. So we'll have 8 mana, so we will be able to hit 6 cards out of his hand. So if he draws something and doesn't cast anything, then we can hit his whole hand. I think it's pretty likely that if he draws a land, he'll play a spell as well, so he'll actually go down to 5 cards, and then we'll still be able to get his whole hand next turn. So I think I'd rather actually just kill the favorite hoplite. This also just, I feel like, gives him way fewer opportunities to blow us out if he has fewer creatures in play. Yeah, I guess we want a Gore Clan. I think it's good enough. Makes our guy much bigger than his. Alright, well, he drew a tapped land, which was actually somewhat unexpected, I would say. I didn't expect him to have any temples in this deck. So he's still blocking, so he's still going to go down to 5 cards, presumably. Because he looks like he's going to, going to be God's Willing or Ajani's Presence or whatever. So let's just get that whole hand out of here. Alright, that was sufficient. So it looks like he has a ton of protection spells. If he's playing Ajani's Presence, Mizium Skin, and God's Willing, that's just an awful lot of protection spells. Which kind of makes me wonder if the removal plan is actually good, or if just getting him dead is good. I think the removal plan probably still is good, and I still don't think Xenagos or Scavenging Ooze would be particularly interesting, would be particularly good in our strategy right now. The Miscutter I'm still on the fence about, although it seems like most of his heroic guys are not blue, so the pro-blue part, which is what I thought was attractive about it, doesn't sound that appealing. I'm worried that Rakdos Return will be too slow on the draw, but I'm not sure that Golgari Charm will be better because it can't actually kill any of his guys. So I think I'll just leave in the one Rakdos Return.